Welcome, everyone. My name is Sarah Pashapur, and I'm a PhD student in the lab of Professor Joachim Spatz at the Max Planck Institute for Medical Research in Heidelberg. And today I want to explain you a bit about my PhD project, which is all about the generation of extracellular matrix protein-based microcapsules for the investigation of single cells. So we are hypothesizing that by using droplet-based microfluidics, it is possible to establish a polymerized protein layer on the inner periphery of such water and oil droplets, and then by further encapsulating single cells and sequentially releasing our polymerized microcapsules, we are able to investigate fundamental biophysical properties of such single cells with their surrounding ECM. So currently, most of the ECM studies are only conducted from the basal side of such cells, but we wanted to take this a step further and also understand the investigation of the ECM with the apical side of single cells. So basically, we are implementing a 2.5D in vitro technique here. So as I already mentioned, we are using droplet-based microfluidics, which allows us for the parallel encapsulation of cells and proteins in such water and oil droplets. Then by further attracting the proteins to the periphery, we can polymerize them in place and encapsulate single cells by this way. So we can further then release our microcapsules by destabilizing this oil wall, and then we can generate such microcapsules with or without cells at the end. So our droplet stabilized protein capsules look like this here. So basically we have our laminin attracted to the periphery here, or also we use Matrigel where the protein constellation was very diluted basically, that we are not working with a gel. When we even encapsulate HACAT cells, we can still keep our droplet structure alive. And then now the important part is when we release our protein capsules, you can see this very prominent and nicely polymerized structures. And it becomes even more evident when we encapsulate cells, because then you can see the very beautiful tent-like structures of the proteins, which really speaks for a polymerization around our cells. By seeing those healthy and living cells at the end, I come basically directly to my outlook, because now the next steps are the investigation of, for example, cells from the inside and the outside, and understand how they're basically interacting over such protein barriers. Or what we can also do is understand how they're degrading the ECM and even maybe migrating out of it. Another idea is to use those cell-laden microcapsules as building blocks for various tissue types. So what we can do is by mix and matching at the end with using different proteins and different cells, just establish the tissue type of choice at the end. With this, I want to thank you very much for your attention.